Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to another episode here on Gladiator Disc Golf. Today we're talking about part two of building the beginner's bag, fairway drivers. If you're brand new to the channel, I want to welcome you. Thank you so much for coming and stopping by. Please make sure that you guys like this video, hit that subscribe button, and hit that notification bell. Alrighty guys, let's talk about the beginner's bag fairway drivers. To quickly recap what we talked about in the first part of this video, in part one, which I'll put a card right here if you haven't seen it yet, is that for putting putters, we talked about using something that is comfortable in your hand and that you feel confident in when you go to putt with. I didn't make any recommendations for molds because everyone is different in what they like to putt with. But when it comes to throwing putters, I recommended the Pure as your understable putter, the Nova as your stable putter, and then the Zone or Harp as your overstable putter. When it comes to mid-ranges, I recommended either the Discraft Comet or Soul as your understable mid-range, the Dynamic Disc Truth as your stable mid-range, and the Innova Rock as your overstable mid-range. So today we're going to talk about fairway drivers in two categories, and I'll get into that in just a few minutes. All right, but remember guys, this is a video for a beginner's bag. So when we're talking about these fairway drivers, we are not picking something that is super, super overstable for the overstable slot. We are picking discs that beginners can learn to control angles and release points and forehand and backhand and just get really comfortable and being able to get distance out of them. So you might say, oh, well, that's not really an overstable fairway. It's more of a stable fairway, and you're probably right. But for a beginner, what a lot of intermediate, advanced, and pros would consider stable is going to be overstable for a lot of beginners. And so that's why it's going to fit in that category. There are a lot of great fairway drivers in disc golf. Every company has them. I'm still only sticking with Innova, Dynamic Disc, Latitude 64, and Westside, which is Trilogy, and Discraft. However, four fairway drivers, the three best fairway drivers that I found to fill these slots, actually all come from Innova, okay? And so in the comments below, let me know what you would throw in these slots from companies like Dynamic Discs, Westside, Latitude 64, and Discraft. I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say about that. But let's go ahead and let's talk about the understable fairway driver. In this category, I would put the Innova Leopard, which is a 6-speed, 5-glide, minus 2-turn, and 1-fade, or a Leopard 3, which has the same stats except it's 7-speed because it's a flatter top. Now, between these two discs, you're really going based on preference and comfort, okay? A Leopard's gonna have more of a domey top, whereas a Leopard 3 is going to be flatter. And that flatter top is really great for forehands. And so if you're finding yourself to be more forehand dominant, go ahead and throw a Leopard 3. But really they're going to fly pretty much the same, except one is a little bit faster than the other, okay? Once again, all these recommendations, I wanna tell you guys, try them in base plastics first and really learn the discs. If you get an Innova starter pack, you're actually going to get a Leopard in that starter pack. And so if you've grabbed one of those, you already have a disc that I strongly recommend in a pretty light weight. And that's one of the beauties about base plastics, is that they come in really, really light weights for beginners to really learn the game of disc golf. The stable fairway driver, I would recommend the Innova T-Bird, okay? And its flight numbers are 7-speed, 5-glide, 0-turn, and 2-fade. So it's a little bit more stable than a Leopard, but not too overstable. You'll really learn a nice straight flight with a little bit of fade at the end, and a T-Bird is an Innova classic, so is the Leopard, and so you're gonna find it in a variety of plastics. So T-Bird, Leopard, Leopard 3, all great discs. The next one is actually my personal favorite, and it actually beat out the T-Bird for my stable fairway about 2 years ago, and that's the Innova Eagle. And I have this in the overstable slot for beginners because it's 7-speed, 5-glide, minus 1-turn, and 3-fade. So it's a little bit more overstable than the T-Bird, but still a great disc, especially if you get it in a DX plastic. The Eagle Guys is going to be great for really helping you learn how to shape shots because it's a little bit more overstable, but it also has some nice turn to it when you get it really beat in. One of the reasons that the Eagle beat out the T-Bird for me in my bag is that I found that it was easier to forehand the Eagle versus the T-Bird because it has a little bit of extra stability with that three fade. That's pretty much it when it comes to fairway drivers. These are all 6 or 7 speed, and the understable is Leopard or Leopard 3, stable is T-Bird, overstable is Eagle. Now, the video does not end here because I have the next part to fairway drivers, all right? And this is kind of the caveat, all right? If you are finding that you're able to throw these 5, 6, and 7 speeds pretty good, get really good distance on them, maybe even getting close to 300 feet, if not surpassing 300 feet, you may want to try some of these other discs that I'm about to mention in the fairway driver category. However, I still want to caution you because you want to make sure that with these slower speed discs that you're really able to control nose angle, hyzer and anhyzer and flat release, and that you have good form, even if you're getting over 300 feet just based on pure power, because the faster discs are going to be way more finicky and are easier to mess up in a sense, okay? So if you've been throwing 7 speeds and you're pretty good and you're like, oh, I'm ready to move up to a 9 speed, well, the 9 speed is going to be, what's the word I'm looking for? The 9 speed's going to be way more difficult to control its speed and its nose angle because it's going to be thinner and a little bit sharper edge. And so it's just something that I would caution you, wait at least a couple months before you move past 7 speeds, or maybe even a year, depending on how much you can play and how much you progress each time you go out. For an understable fairway driver that's faster than a 7 speed, I'm going to recommend the Innova Roadrunner. We're talking about a great disc. It's a 9 speed, 5 glide, minus 4 turn, and 1 fade. So this disc is just as understable as a sole, but at a much faster speed. And so it's going to really help you learn that nose angle and learn how to get that disc nice and flat and really learn hyzer flips at higher speeds. And so the Innova Roadrunner is a great disc for beginners to sort of start to venture into faster speeds. Also, for the understable, I just saw it in my notes here, I did have the Innova Roadrunner, but I also have the Discraft Heat, okay? And the Discraft Heat is comparable numbers, 9 speed, 6 glide, minus 3 turn, and 1 fade. So pretty comparable to the Roadrunner, except made by a different manufacturer. Now, the Roadrunner, and this is where it gets a little interesting, has a 1.8 centimeter rim, whereas the Heat has a 1.9 centimeter rim. So the Heat's rim is a little bit wider than the Roadrunner's. And so what you'll really want to do, because they do pretty much fly the same, when you go to a shop, go and hold both of them and see which one feels more comfortable in your hand, and that's the one that you're going to want to throw, because regardless of flight numbers, guys, comfort is key when it comes to disc golf. You want to throw something that feels comfortable in your hand. For the stable fairway driver, I'm going to recommend the Dynamic Discs Escape. All right, and I know for a fact that you can find a Prime, which is the base plastic for Dynamic Disc Escape, at Academy, because that's where I got my first Escape. It is a great stable fairway driver. It has 9 speed, 5 glide, minus 1 turn, and 2 fade. So you're still getting a little bit of turn, but you're getting a little bit more stability on the fade end, so it's gonna bite a little bit harder than a Roadrunner and Heat. But also, just like the understable fairway driver, I do have a second recommendation for a stable fairway, and that is the Westside Stack, a super underappreciated and sort of under the radar disc that is absolutely phenomenal. The Stag is 8 speed, 6 glide, minus 1 turn, and 2 fade. Now, just like the Roadrunner and Heat, the difference between these two discs is rim width. All right, the Escape has a 2 centimeter rim width versus the Stag's 1.9 centimeter rim width. So it depends on comfort. But something to think about is the Heat has a 1.9 centimeter rim width, and the Stag has a 1.9 centimeter rim width, and they fly a little bit different. So if you find that you really like the Heat and it feels great in your hand, you're probably going to want to try the Stag because the rim width is exactly the same. And so you're not going to be changing too much of your grip to adjust to a bigger rim, but you're going to get a more overstable disc, which is what we're looking for here in the stable mid-range, in the stable fairway category, for it to be a little bit more stable than the understable. And then the last one is the overstable fairway driver. Now, for most players, this is gonna be something like a Firebird, but for a beginner, I am recommending one of my favorite discs, and that is the Innova Thunderbird. The Innova Thunderbird is 9-speed, 5-glide, 0-turn, and 2-fade. And it's an absolutely great disc, available in a variety of plastics. I recommend either in the DX or Pro plastic because you get a little bit more glide and a little bit more flight with that Pro plastic. And that's my go-to driver in any of my play around videos. If you've watched them and you've seen a purple disc come out of the bag with no stamp on it, that's a Pro Thunderbird, and that thing bombs. I absolutely love it. It's my favorite. Obviously, I'm a little biased about it, but I will say this. If I did not throw the Innova Thunderbird, I would definitely be throwing the Westside Stag. And so I recommend both of those discs for those two categories, but you can't go wrong with any of the options that I gave you guys here. So that was part two, building a beginner's bag with fairway drivers. I hope you guys found this helpful. Let me know in the comments below which of these molds you want to throw, or a disc that's not in this list but can fill one of these slots. There are so many companies out there, guys. There's no way I could have possibly picked from every single company and trust that they are all easily accessible, okay? And that's the biggest thing for beginners, is getting an easily accessible disc, especially when they lose one or it beats in or it breaks, you know, if you're playing in really cold temperatures. So that was the focus here. So with manufacturers that are found everywhere and molds that are found everywhere and are never out of stock. That's all I have for today. I hope you found this video super helpful. If you haven't watched part one, make sure you go back and watch it to learn a little bit more about some great throwing putters and mid-ranges. Until next time, have a great round.